We are all familiar with the power that the dark side of the Force wields, and some of these Sith Lords know the so-called unlimited power all too well. Now, you might not know all of the Sith Lords in this list due to them not appearing in the movies, but that is why we are here to introduce them to you. Stick around and enjoy as we unveil the top 10 strongest Sith Lords of all time. Number 10, Darth Vader, Anakin Skywalker. If Darth Vader is on the 10th spot on the list, you might be wondering what is coming up next. Well, grab some popcorn and enjoy our list of the top 10 strongest Sith Lords. Now, Midi-Chlorian is the measurement of the power of a Force sentient. And, strangely enough, Anakin was the Jedi with the highest Midi-Chlorian of all time. However, he never managed to reach his full potential. Nevertheless, he still managed to reserve a spot on our list, as he gave himself to the dark side and thus made himself a Sith Lord who was carrying a profound anger and sense of loss inside him, which eventually led to his failure. One of his biggest achievements was that he became the ultimate Jedi killer and his personal mission to conduct the Great Jedi Purge. Number 9. Freedan Nadd. Don't worry if the name doesn't sound familiar, but Freedan Nadd was a Sith Lord in a very ancient world, in an era that far preceded the previous Sith. He was once a Jedi, but after killing his master, he fled and joined the old Sith Order as an apprentice of the Sith Lord Naga Sidow. As a Sith Lord, he was more on the sorcerer side of things, as he was able to control the Force better than his lightsaber. After learning everything he could from his master, he destroyed him and became a Dark Lord himself. All of his life he ruled over Onderon, and after his death, he was buried there, and his tomb remained a powerful hotspot for Sith power. He would later be resurrected and took on a new apprentice, one that was meant to be the strongest Sith Lord of all time. Number 8. Darth Bane, Desol. Darth Bane has to be one of the most powerful Sith Lords out there. He is the one responsible for creating the Law of Two, which speaks highly of him. He has also created his own Sith Order, instructed by the old Sith Order and Sith Council, which he taught was weak. He studied Darth Revan's holocron and managed to create his own Sith Order after destroying the old one. When an attempt to create his own holocron to pass down to further Sith Lords, the Jedi sent a task force to kill him. However, he, together with his apprentice, despite outnumbered, they managed to kill each and every one of them, a fact speaking of his power. And also his Sith Order, many years after his passing, was the Sith Order that would overthrow the Republic. Number 7. Marco Ragnos. Next on the list, we have Marco Ragnos, who is the opposite of what Freedan Nadd was. Unlike him, Marco was not really top-notch with the Force. But if you loved lightsaber combat, then he is the one you will like the most. It is considered that he is the best duelist in the entire Star Wars saga. He was admired by many as the best in dueling, and he has defeated everyone who challenged him in a single combat. Darth Vitiate was his apprentice, who is another great Sith, and after his death, he even came back as a spirit. While alive, he was unchallenged and reigned supreme for about 100 years, and his spirit wandered for millenniums before being sealed off by a Jedi forever. It's a shame he lacked in the Force side of things. He would have been ranked much higher on our list if that was the case. Number 6. Ulic Keldroma. Ulic was a Jedi on a mission, and a one who has a turmoil of a past. He was injected with a rage-augmenting chemical that made him slowly but surely fall to the dark side. Then, he went to Nadd's apprentice, the greatest Sith Lord in existence. But we shall not name him yet. They went on to duel each other to see who will become a Sith Lord. The battle is stopped by Nadd's spirit, and both of them would become Sith Lords. Together, they would go on an assault on the Republic, where Ulic coldly kills his Jedi brother. Nomi Sunrider, as one of the greatest Jedis ever, uses her power to sever the connection between Ulic and the Force. And he goes in exile together with Nomi's daughter as his apprentice, leaving behind nothing but his dominance while under the control of the dark side of the Force. Number 5. Darth Plagueis. Now you might be wondering, how did this guy get on this list? Well, to start off, he wasn't really good with the Force or the lightsaber combat, He was in control, but he didn't excel at it. He went through many things, awful things, which many others would pass on from or even avoid. But he did it in the name of knowledge. And according to him, knowledge was everything. Thus, he is on our list for one reason only, and he was the best at it. He is considered Sis Ultimate Scholar, the best teacher anyone could have. Throughout his life, he was obsessed with tricking death and achieving immortality, conducting a lot of experiments along the way in order of achieving extensive knowledge. And this knowledge was put to worth when his apprentice, Darth Sidious, managed to cheat death. Yes, Darth Plagueis is the master of Darth Vader's master. Number 4. Darth Sidious, Senator Palpatine. Darth Sidious is, as we mentioned before, the apprentice of Darth Plagueis. He is the meme guy with lightning coming out of his hands. Now, when that is out of the picture, we move on. Darth Sidious took over the face of the politician as a facade to hide his true intentions of taking over the whole galaxy. He also broke the rule of two while being an apprentice, as he took on Darth Maul as his apprentice. He usurped the throne by killing his master in his sleep, and he turned the Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker into his apprentice Darth Vader. Both of them together formed the Galactic Empire, and he was also killed by his apprentice, living the same fate as his masters. But he didn't stay for long. He had the knowledge and cheater death. However, he was forced to change bodies frequently to stay alive. And lastly, one of his allies sabotaged the fresh supply of clones. He didn't succeed in moving to one of his clones and perished forever. Number 3. Revan. Revan has to be the favorite from the dark side for many, and here is why. He was a Jedi who wanted to protect countless lives on the Outer Rim when the Mandalorian invasion happened, but he wasn't led to do it. So by his best diplomatic abilities and leadership virtues, he gathered an enormous number of Jedi to fight for him, disobeying the council in the process. Him, together with his Padawan Malak and everyone who followed, he managed to win the war for the Republic. But the group didn't return, and they found the Star Forge, a shipyard that would later allow him to amass a great fleet and power, in the meantime seducing him to become a Sith. He was also known as a powerful Sith Lord who could turn Jedi at his will and gain allies from everywhere, making him one of the strongest Sith Lords out there. Number 2. Darth Vitiate. Darth Vitiate is for sure one of the strongest Sith Lords of all time. With just the age of 10, he killed his father with only a thought. Can you imagine that? This suited him. As we can see, later on in his life, he would go on to kill up an entire planet, including Sith Lords and Jedis alike. He also would absorb their powers, and in doing so, he only grew stronger and stronger. And at one point, he became immortal. Well, almost. He is dead now, but he lived for millenniums after his birth. And you can't just be immortal and not be that strong, right? Thus, his long life makes him the Sith Lord who reigned the longest. In a battle once, he bested Revan and was Darth Plagueis' muse, since Plagueis envied his knowledge, which Vitiate possessed from all the years he had lived to that moment. And we know that Darth Plagueis is all about that knowledge. Number 1. Exar Kun. And last but not least, we have Exar Kun, the most powerful Sith of all time. Even when he was a Jedi, he wanted to become stronger and stronger. His desire for power made him leave the Order in pursuit of forbidden teachings. After he left the Order, he visited the tomb of Freedon Nadd, who we mentioned before, and he taught him everything he could before he got killed. He then traveled to Yavin 4, where he amassed to even greater power. He killed many Sith cults who were too strong for his liking, and stole an ancient holocron, which he later used to make him even stronger. He used his powers to turn many Jedi Padawans to the dark side and convince them to kill their masters. He also killed the Supreme Chancellor of the Jedi Order, who was no match for him. He was also attacked by Ulic and thousands of troops. When he separated his body and spirit, he was incarcerated by Nomi and many Jedis in a temple forever. On a related note, tell us which of these Sith Lords is to your liking in the comment section down below. And also, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you would like to see some more videos like this in the future, hit the bell icon for any new notifications coming your way. Thank you for watching, and we will see you next time.